हेलो लर्नर्स, टुडे वी विल लर्न एंड अंडरस्टैंड रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ रेशनल नंबर्स ऑन द नंबर लाइन। टू रिप्रेजेंट ए रेशनल नंबर ऑन द नंबर लाइन इट इज रिक्वायर्ड टू नो फर्स्ट व्हाट इज रेशनल नंबर। आई हैव शोन हियर A rational number is any real number that can be expressed as a simple fraction or ratio. By definition, a rational number is a number which can be written in the form of p by q, where p and q are any two integers and q is not equal to 0. Rational numbers can be positive or negative. If we take a closer look at counting numbers, all of them are rational number with denominator 1. The capital letter Q is the symbol of rational number which represents the set of rational number. Example you have learnt in class 7 also. Examples is here 4, 1 by 2, 7 by 5, etc. It is a positive rational number. Here in the right hand side of this image, I have written minus 4, minus 1 by 5, minus 7 by 3, etc. It is the example of negative rational number. So this image says something. You understand this one. Now we have learnt in previous class how to represent natural number on number line. Here in the first A, this line extends in indefinite only to the right side of 1. When we are representing a natural number on the number line, you see whole numbers, it is also on the represent on that line which extends indefinitely to the right, but from zero there are no numbers to the left of zero. Integers having negative and positive part. So the line extends indefinitely on both sides. Do you see any number between minus 1, 0, 0, 1, etc. Here represented. Rational number also you have learned. We have already learned how to represent rational number on a number line. We shall revise with the help of a few examples. You know very well. But before giving the examples, listen to this carefully. Every natural number is a rational number. Clear? All whole numbers are a rational number. Every integer is a rational number. This is the property and it is shown in the figures. Figure above. Every fraction is a rational number. You know very well a proper fraction and improper fraction. In proper fraction, numerator less than denominator. In short, we can write numerator less than denominator. Improper fractions in which numerator greater than denominator. In short, we can write n greater than d. Now, we are going to represent the rational number on the number line. It is very important to us that in number line the zero is called the origin. All the positive values are represented on the right side of the origin and the negative values are represented on the left side of the origin. Is clear? Now take an example to understand in a better way with this example. Now we are going to represent 1 by 3 on the number line. Since 1 by 3 is less than 1, it will be lies between 0 and 1. Then draw a line and mark a point O, point O on it to represent 0 and take 1 unit equivalent to 3 cm. That means 1 unit equal to 3 centimeter. Okay, there I have represented here. Mark point representing 1 on number line as A, I have represented here. Divide this OA into 3 equal parts as denominator is 3. Dear learners, we will see the denominator. Denominator. Okay. According to denominator, whatever the 3 is there, 4 is there, 5 is there, 6 is there, we will divide OA in the as required. What denominator given in the rational number? This point divided in equal 3 parts, with this point denoted by A1 and A2. Each part is 1 by 3 of a 1 unit. So I have represented here. So our we get the answer, and in the last we will write, hence point A1 represents the rational number 1 by 3. Is clear? Now we are going to represent rational number 7 by 4 on the number line. Is clear? Since we know very well and you are very familiar about that, here the here we see, since 7 by 4 is greater than 1, that means the value will lies between 1 and 2. So first we draw a line and mark a point O on it, to represent 0, and take 1 unit equivalent to 4 centimeter. Here I have represented 0 here and 1 and 2. Just I have said to explaining number line that all the positive values are represented on the right side of the origin. Is clear? So that's why 7 by 4 is positive rational number. We are representing all the values, positive values, in the right side of the 0. Now here mark point A, 1 as a A and 2 as a B. Yes, this one have represented here. Divide AB into 4 equal parts. Sir, we can divide OA in 4 equal parts? Yes, we can divide it for your convenience, for easy to understand. But I have taken AB, which I have divided in 4 equal parts. Each equal parts is 1 by 4 of 1 unit, that is will be of length 1 centimeter. Suppose you have taken 1 unit is equal to 2 centimeter, then each part will be of length 1 by 2 centimeter. Is clear? So I have putted this one, I have divided and putted point 1, 2, 3. It divided in 4 part AB equally. Represent the points by A1, A2 and A3, which divided by us in 4 equal part, but point is containing 3. B is also 4. So you see here I have plotted the values and also symbol. A1, A2, A3, isn't it? Sir, here 1, that means what, sir? Here 1 is means 4 by 4 equal to 1. Then 1 by 4, 2 by 4, 3 by 4, 4 by 4, we get 1. Now, because 7 by 4 is an improper fraction, when we change the 7 by 4, we get the 1 whole and 3 by 4 as a fraction. So 4 by 4 here, in the next point we'll write 5 by 4, next point 6 by 4, next point 7 by 4, and the next we will write 8 by 4, we get 2. It's clear. So such type we can take precaution to representing the rational number on number line. So it is for plus I have done, and third I am going to representing the minus 74 on the number line. So we will do that like, and I have explained the negative values are represented on the left side of the origin. It's clear. So we will take 0 where, since minus 7 by 4 less than minus 1, it lies between minus 1 and minus 2. Draw a line and mark a point O on it to represent O 0, and take 1 unit equivalent to 4 cm. 1 unit equal to 4 cm is clear. And here showing by this diagram, I have plotted here. Mark point minus 1 as A dash and minus 2 as B dash. I have represented here. And I opted already here. Divide AB into, A dash and B dash into 4 equal parts. Each equal part is 1 by 4 of 1 unit. Will be of length 1 centimeter. If you have taken 1 unit equal to 2 centimeter, then each part will be of length 1 by 2 centimeter. Is clear? After dividing this one, we will represent the numbers as per our knowledge. They are here. Here is minus 1. That means it is minus 4 by 4. We get minus 1. Then minus 4 by 4. Next number will be minus 5 by 4. We have written here. Minus 6 by 4. We have written here. Because we require to represent the minus 7 by 4. No, that's why we will represent this one on the number line. And minus 2. Minus 2 means 8 by 2. Then we get minus 2. Okay. So our required rational number representing by A3 point. Okay. So I have written point A-3 represent the rational number minus 7 by 5. When we represent this one together, minus 7 by 5 or minus plus 7 by 5. So it's always keep in our mind that all the positive values are represented on the right side of the origin and the negative values are represented on the left side of the origin. And also main point here, see the denominator which indicate us to divide unit into how many equal parts. How many equal parts? Okay. For instance, suppose our denominator is 4. That means equal parts equal to 4. If denominator is 6, equal parts is 6. If the rational number proper fraction, each fraction is a rational number. If it is improper fraction, first of all convert into mixed fraction, then we will represent the rational number on the number line. I hope that this class is very helpful to those students that make him understand how to represent the rational number on the number line. Isn't it, my dear learner? Isn't it? Found this video helpful? You can give comments. I hope this helped you in your future. Okay, have a nice day to all. Thank you.